Dallas, leading the Packers back from a 15-point deficit, including that touchdown drive in the last minute. Rodgers, though, isn't getting all the credit for the win, with some blaming Jason Garrett of the Cowboys for leaving time on the clock for the world's best quarterback. All right, Whitlock, do you blame the Cowboys for leaving Aaron Rodgers too much time?
Yeah, I really do. And listen, when that game was over, I had the biggest smile, the most satisfied look in my life. This is why I watch the NFL, for these type moments and for Aaron Rodgers to make me feel like a kid again. And so I don't want to take anything away from Aaron Rodgers. But when Jason Garrett was throwing the ball at the end of that Dallas drive and not milking the clock, realizing, because my whole thought was, if there's 50 seconds, 45 seconds on the clock, Aaron Rodgers is going to tie this game or win it. Jason Garrett managed them into this situation, and Aaron Rodgers ate him alive.
Let me defend Jason Garrett. Okay.
Please, I can't wait.
It's hard to win in this league. Okay, Andy Reid has only been to one Super Bowl. When you have a chance to score, I'm going to sit and worry about, okay, after we score, I just want to score. Like, you're making it sound like Dallas is like, okay, we know we're going to score. Let's just milk the clock. How about
it was second and one, and they threw the ball.
Oh, by the way, Atlanta, Detroit, 8 inches. That's the league. You're making it sound like Dallas knew they were going to score. On a fourth down yesterday, Dallas got a break from the officials, or the game would have been over then. On the Ezekiel Elliott reaching over?
Second and one. Zeke is running you down the field. Hand Zeke the ball. Milk the clock. I'm not throwing a fade. I think it was a fade to Dez Bryant.
I didn't love the call, but I find it funny. We're always like, hey, I mean, how can you give Aaron Rodgers that much time? Aaron's done this 48 times because teams are just trying to get into the end zone. You'll worry about that to me later. I just want to score. Am I nuts on this?
No, I don't think so at all. I agree with you 100%. As an offensive player in those situations that we've been in, that is you just got to get it. You got to get in. I mean, you saw the play too. It was a little fake to Ezekiel, and then Dak took it in, right? I don't think that you say to yourself, okay, well, the end zone's right there. Fall down because we don't want to leave much time left.
He threw two passes
right
that were incomplete on that final series. He stopped the clock. He could have just kept running Zeke. That's the issue.
Nah, I don't know. I just think right now. We all said it, too. When we were watching the game, we're like, uh-oh, a timeout with a minute left on a brilliant 17-play drive? I mean, that was 8 of 9 minutes. I just don't think that you can look that far into the future.
That's exactly right. I mean, look, all the conversation at your philosophy is talked about the night before as a coaching staff. You get together. Hey, are we a play for the last shot team? Are we freewheeling? But usually that comes right before the half. You know, what's going to be our philosophy? Well, let's eat it. We'll keep running the ball. We'll do things and play for the last shot, not give the ball back. But that happens right before the half. This is at the end of the game situation. And Jason, they had, like Tony said, there's an 8 or 9 minute drive. It was awesome the way they were running the football, 8 yards a shot. I mean, you could all of us could sit back and say, hey, you're going to score here because how poorly the Packers were playing defense and how well they were running. But, you know, you do have Dez, and that if there's an automatic receiver in that low red zone, it's Dez. You got one-on-one. He is so good at catching the ball there.
It's like, you know, I
took one
space?
Shot, but they still...
You are.
They still got it in. But the thing I have a problem, it's not Jason Garrett. I think they did a good job of managing the clock and getting it down there. Okay, they gave it to him with a minute, you know, whatever the time was. I think they did a poor job of executing what Marinelli was calling, and then he had a lousy call in the red zone, which, how about a little heat on their defense? 4 for 4 with Denver, make that guy look like John Elway a few weeks ago, 4-4 in the red zone. Now they're 4 for 5 in this game. They're not playing the right call. They're in a field call, which is 2-man cover 5 with low inside help and a half field safety. Well, you can't play that in that red zone. 10 yard, you're on a 10-yard. You can't play it there. The safety will never get over the top. And so the corner, he does exactly how he's coached. The safety does exactly how he's coached. And they win the game with a touchdown. If you want to blame somebody from Dallas, blame that guy.
Here's the other thing. Seattle yesterday was in the red zone like 5 times. And they scored 3 points. To my point is, when you are on a 17-play drive, you're facing the Packers. It's national TV. I got a second-year quarterback. I'm not sitting worried about clock. I want to just get the ball in the end zone. So we can always look at and say, they should have thrown there. But I think I watched Seattle yesterday. They're in that red zone all day long. They got a field goal.
You're comparing Seattle to Dallas with Zeke.
You sound like a columnist.
No. What I said, it's like I'm in outer space. You're talking about Aaron Rodgers is on the other side. You know how I would have rather lost that game? 4th and 1 from the 2-yard line and a bad offensive play call, and we just lost.
You'd rather lose that way?
Because we then giving this
in short yardage.
Then to give this man the ball with a minute left, so, you knew that was dead.
So what's the column? No way. What's the column you write in Dallas? You're the columnist for the Dallas Morning
Jason
News.
Garrett. You know what my number one saying is to friends? And know your personnel. And that means not just your personnel, but the opposing personnel. The entire time I'm playing those guys in that uniform, I'm thinking, I don't want that dude over there to kill me. I'll die any other way than having that dude, the ultimate killer, kill me. I would have rather lost the game with him standing on the sideline watching my offense sputter out with its running game.
There's never been an owner that said you're fired because of the way you lost. They just fire you for losing. You're trying to find ways, better ways to lose. Win games.
The terrible thing is everybody's trying to hide. Look, don't put that defense out there. They were only out there for 25 minutes. I mean, you know, they were only out there for 25 minutes.
There's not one person here that knew when Aaron Rodgers ran back on the field with a minute, game over.
Yeah, everybody knew it.
Especially when you don't keep them contained in cover 5. You have no chance.
Everybody knew it, but yeah, let's give them the ball back with a minute.
Yeah, but you got to do a – I mean, you got to think you can stop them. I mean –
No, you don't. Haven't you watched Aaron Rodgers?
I have, but somebody put a mirror in front of him. Somebody's got to contain him. Someone's got to play in the B gap when they run the football, and there's nobody there.
The guy's like 10 years in. He can't be stopped.
There's nothing you could have done. They did what they had to do, a 17-play drive, 9 minutes off the clock. They did what they had to do.
What if that was a 9?